Welcome to solution of a system of linear simultaneous equation by matrix method. इसके पहले हम लोग देख लिए हैं इनवर्स निकालना. अब लीनियर साइमल्टेनियस इक्वेशन है. फर्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस होमोजीनियस लीनियर इक्वेशंस एंड देन वी विल डिस्कस नॉन होमोजीनियस केस. फर्स्ट होमोजीनियस लीनियर इक्वेशंस. Let us have a system of m homogeneous equations in n unknowns. The unknowns are x1, x2, x3, so on, xn. So we have m equations in n unknowns. a11 x1 plus a12 x2 plus 1 plus a1n xn is equal to 0. a21 x1 plus a22 x2 plus 1 plus a2n xn is equal to 0 and so on. The mth equation is am1 x1 plus am2 x2 plus 1 plus amn xn is equal to 0. This is our homogeneous linear system of equations. So this one system can be written in a matrix form as A into X is equal to O, where this A is a matrix formed with the coefficients. So capital A is equal to matrix A11, A12, so on, A1n, A21, A22, so on, A2n, and AM1. AM2, so on, AMN is called the coefficient matrix. And this capital X is X1, X2, so on, XN, n by 1 matrix, this is a column matrix. And this O, this is your null matrix, 0, 0, 0, so on, 0, m by 1 matrix. These are M0s, these are NX. So this, the whole system 1 can be written as A into X is equal to O. Now, we will have trivial solution, or you can say self-obvious solution, means x equal to O, means x equal to this null matrix. It means x1 is 0, x2 is 0, and so on, xn is 0. If all the variables are 0, then your system 1 is satisfied. So this is the case when we say the solution to be trivial or self-obvious. See here, there is a result. The number of linearly independent solutions of m homogeneous linear equations in n variables, A into X is equal to O, is n minus r, where this r, small r, is what? This r is rho A. Rho A means rank of A. So if there are n variables and r is the rank of the matrix A, then the total number of linearly independent solutions will be n minus r. We will make use of this in our problems. Now, let us see nature of solutions of the equations AX is equal to O. Means when this system have solution and when this system have no solution and when this system have infinite number of solutions. See, let A is your AIJ and M by N be a coefficient matrix of M by N type, and rho A is equal to small r, means rank of this matrix A is small r. We have m equations in n variables. So this r can be greater than or equal to 0 and less than or equal to minimum of m or n. Since for a matrix A of m by n type, the rank of the matrix A will be less than or equal to m or n, minimum of m or n. Now we have case one, when r is equal to small n, means number of variables. In this case, the equation AX is equal to O will have n minus r equal to n minus n, means 0, linearly independent solution. Hence, the 0 solution will be the only solution. Therefore, X will be your null matrix O. Now come to case 2, r is less than n. The equation AX is equal to O will have n minus r linearly independent solution. Here, AX is equal to O will have an infinite number of solutions. Since if we have a solution x1, then we have also solution kx1, k1x1, k2x2, and so on. So in this case, when r is less than n, then the system AX is equal to O will have infinite number of solutions. Now come to case 3, r is less than or equal to m, less than n. In this case also, the equation AX is equal to O, it will have an infinite number of solutions. See, we have one example that will clear your idea. See, solve completely the system of equations x plus 3y minus 2z is equal to 0. 2x minus y plus 4z is equal to 0. X minus 11y plus 14z is equal to 0. See here, the right hand side member in each equation is 0. So this is our homogeneous linear system of equations. This can be written as A into x is equal to O, where this A is your coefficient matrix and x is your variables matrix made from variables x, y, and z. And this O is your null matrix 0, 0, 0. So proceed on to its solution. Or the given system of equations can be written as 1, 3, minus 2, 2, minus 1, 4, 1, minus 11, 14, x, y, z is equal to 0, 0, 0. See this 1, 3, minus 2, this is the coefficient of x, y, z in your first equation. 2, minus 1, 4, coefficients of x, y, z in second equation. And 1, minus 11, 14, coefficients of x, y, z in your third equation. So the given homogeneous linear system of equations is written in this form, matrix form, Ax is equal to O. Now we reduce this coefficient matrix A to echelon form by applying only elementary row operations on it. We have studied earlier what the echelon form is, and we will reduce this matrix A to echelon form by applying what? Only elementary row operations. So it means the first element in each row must be equal to 1. And from second row, we should have 0 at the place 2, 1. And third row at the place 3, 1. See, it can be done by R2 goes to R2 minus 2, R1. So this R2 will change to R2 minus 2, R1. Multiply the row 1 by 2 and subtract it from row 2. So it will be 1, 3 minus 2. 2 into 1, 2 minus 2 into 1, this is your 0. Minus 1 minus 2 into 3 means minus 7. 4 minus 2 into minus 2, this is your plus 8. And this is your y. Next third is your r3 goes to r3 minus r1 because this 1 minus 1 is 0. Minus 11 minus 3 is 14. 14 minus minus 2 is your 16. And this is your x, y, z, 0, 0, 0. Now, R3 goes to R3 minus 2 R2, apply here, R3, so it will be 1, 3 minus 2, 0 minus 7, 8, and this is your 0 minus 2 into 0, so it is 0, minus 14 minus 2 into minus 7, it is 0, and 16 minus 2 into 8 means it is 0, x, y, z, 0, 0, 0. Now we should have minus 1 here, in the second row, 1 here, so R2 goes to R, minus 1 by 7 R2, so it is 1, 3 minus 2, 0, 1, minus 8 by 7, 0, 0, 0, x, y, z, 0, 0, 0. See here, this matrix is your in echelon form because the third row is containing all the elements 0 and before the second row contains only one element 0, first element and the second element is 1 and in the first row, the first element is 0, 1. So this is our echelon form. This echelon form means this is reduced coefficient matrix. It has two non-zero rows. So the row of A is equal to the number of non-zero rows. So it is equal to 2. Kyunki is matrix mein do non-zero row hamara hai, isliye iska rank ho jayega 2. Therefore, Ax is equal to O will have n minus r linearly independent solutions. N means 3, minus r means 2. So 3 minus 2 means 1, 1 linearly independent solutions. From 2, expand these 2, you will get x plus 3y minus 2z equal to 0, y minus 8 by 7z is equal to 0. Take z is equal to lambda, then y is your 8 by 7 lambda from this equation and substitute the values of y and z here in this first equation and you get x is equal to minus 3 into 8 by 7 lambda plus 2 into lambda, so it is minus 10 by 7 lambda. It means your x becomes minus 10 by 7 lambda. 8 by 7 lambda and lambda, take a lambda outside. So it is equal to lambda into minus 10 by 7, 8 by 7, 1. This is the general solution of the given system where this lambda is any arbitrary parameter. See, for different values of lambda, we have different solutions, but all of them are linearly dependent. Only one linearly independent solution we have, and all other are linearly dependent. There is an example for you to practice. See the example. Solve completely the system of equations x plus y plus z equal to 0, 2xy minus y minus 3z is equal to 0, 3x minus 5y plus 4z is equal to 0, and x plus 17y plus 4z is equal to 0. See here the right hand side member means after right hand side to equality sign, all of them are 0. So this is the case of your homogeneous linear system of equations. You can solve it using our earlier solution method. So you will have no difficulty. Now we come to your solution of linear non-homogeneous equation. The equations are a11x1 plus a12x2 plus so on plus a1n xn is equal to b1, a21x1 plus a22x2 plus so on plus a2n xn is equal to b2, and so on am1x1 plus am2x2 plus so on plus amn xn is equal to bm. See here, the right hand side of equality sign have non-zero numbers. So this is your non-homogeneous case. This system can be written as A into X is equal to B, where A is your coefficient matrix. It is equal to A11, A12, so on, A1n, A21, A22, so on, A21, and AM1, AM2, so on, AMN. This is your M by N matrix. Capital X is your column matrix, X1, X2, so on, Xn, N by 1 matrix, and capital B is your column matrix, B1, B2, so on, Bm, M by 1 matrix. Any set of values of X1, X2, so on, Xn that simultaneously satisfy all these equations is known as solution of the system. Suppose we have a set of values of x1, x2, so on, xn, which satisfy all these equations, all these m equations. Only then that set will be called a solution of this system 1. So see here what is the meaning of consistent, inconsistent, and augment matrix. We will make use of this. Consistent, when one or more solutions exist of a simultaneous non-homogeneous linear system or system of equations will be called consistent if there exist one or more solutions. Inconsistent if there exists no solution. Augmented matrix, see, A, B is your called augmented matrix. It is given as A11, A12, so on, A1n, A21, A2, so on, A2n, and A1, A1, so on, AMN, and augmented by B1, B2, so on, BM. This the elements of column B is written here at the right hand side. So this is called as augmented matrix. See, note the system of equations AX is equal to B is consistent, that is has a solution if and only if the coefficient matrix A and the augmented matrix AB are of the same rank. Means rho A is equal to rho of AB. So this is very good technique to check whether the given system of equations, non-homogeneous equations, have a solution or is consistent or not. So you need to check only this rho of A is equal to rho of AB. Means rho of the coefficient matrix A is equal to rho of the augmented matrix AB. So there are some rules, and after that we will have an example. It will be discussed in your next class. So it is over for today. And if you have any query or any difficulty, you just ask me here. I will upload this on YouTube, so you can see the lecture on YouTube also.